हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, कैन यू सी द पिक्चर ओवर हियर एंड कैन यू रेक्टिफाई व्हाट इज इट अबाउट? यस, अबाउट द बैंगल्स एंड आर टुडेज चैप्टर, दैट इज द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ पोएट्री सेक्शन ऑफ क्लास 9, द बैंगल सेलर्स बाय सरोजनी नायडू. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ. Before I begin with, students, can you identify this personality? Yes, Sarojini Naidu. Sarojini Naidu was an Indian politician and poet. She was an important figure in India's struggle for independence from colonial rule. Naidu's work as a poet earned her the sobriquet Nightingale of India. Students, you know what is the meaning of sobriquet? It means the nickname. And Mahatma Gandhi gave her this nickname or the title Nightingale of India. That is, she's also called the Bharat Kokila. Can you answer me who is also called the Bharat Kokila? Yes, Lata Mangeshkar. But before her, Sarojini Naidu was given this title. You can write the spelling of sobriquet. Sobriquet means the nickname. Now, today we are going to deal with the Bangle Sellers, one of her beautiful and rhythmic poem. And because of her contribution to poetry, she was given this title. See, the Bangle Sellers. You can see that a group of bangle sellers are on their way to the temple fair to sell their beautiful bangles for different age groups of women. The bangle sellers are trying to convince in the temple fair to sell their bangles. You can just see. And he is carrying different types or colorful bangles for different age groups. You can see silver, blue color bangles, which symbolizes freshness. You can see reddish colored bangles. You can see green color bangles, resembles the freshness of newborn leaves. Then the other bangles are made for the bride, that are the yellow and red bangles. These are referred as fire colored bangles, which are made for the bride. Then we will find in this poem, in the last stanza, that some bangles are also meant for housewives, mothers, or the middle-aged woman. Those are gold and grey flecked bangles. Now, students, we will begin with our poem, The Bangle Sellers by Sarojini Naidu. See, before I start the poem, the theme of the poem is the celebration of Indian womanhood. Sarojini Naidu describes each stage of a woman with a color that is suitable for every age. The poem shows the life of a woman from a dreamy maiden to an excited bride and then to a faithful wife, a mother, or a middle-aged woman. Now, you can think that how is the bangle sellers relevant in today's world? See, the poem revolves around bangles, and bangles, we all know, is an important ornament of women of every age in Indian society, and that is why Sarojini Naidu has beautifully tried to show द ट्रेडिशन एंड कल्चर ऑफ इंडियन सोसाइटी थ्रू हर पोयम. लेट्स बिगिन. बैंगल सेलर्स आर वी हु बियर आर शाइनिंग लोड्स टू द टेम्पल फेयर. हु विल बाय दिस डेलिकेट ब्राइट रेनबो टिंटेड सर्कल्स ऑफ लाइट लास्ट्रस टोकन्स ऑफ रेडियंट लाइफ फॉर हैप्पी डॉटर्स एंड हैप्पी वाइफ. नाउ हु इज द स्पीकर. सो बैंगल सेलर्स आर द स्पीकर्स हु बेयर आर शाइनिंग लोड्स टू द टेम्पल फेयर. यू कैन अंडरलाइन शाइनिंग लोड्स. इट्स अ मेटाफर फिगर ऑफ स्पीच बिकॉज दे आर कैरिंग दिस ब्यूटिफुल शाइनिंग बैंगल्स टू द टेम्पल फेयर. नाउ वाई आर द बैंगल सेलर्स आर गोइंग टू द टेम्पल फेयर टू सेल देयर प्रोडक्ट बिकॉज टेम्पल फेयर इज द प्लेस विच इज विजिटेड बाई वुमेन ऑफ ऑल एज ग्रुप्स. हियर दे कैन सेल देयर गुड्स दैट इज द बैंगल्स टू हैप्पी डॉटर्स एंड हैप्पी वाइफ. नाउ हु विल बाय दिस डेलिकेट ब्राइट. सो हु आर द एक्सपेक्टेड बायर्स. द एक्सपेक्टेड बायर्स आर द वुमेन ऑफ एवरी एज ग्रुप हु विल बाय दिस प्रोडक्ट. लस्ट्रस टोकन्स ऑफ रेडियंट लाइफ. लस्ट्रस टोकन्स मीन शाइनिंग कलरफुल टोकन गिफ्ट ऑफ रेडियंट कलरफुल एंड ब्राइट लाइफ हैप्पी लाइफ इन द फ्यूचर टू द वियरर फॉर हैप्पी डॉटर्स एंड हैप्पी वाइफ. स्टूडेंट्स अंडरलाइन रेनबो टिंटेड सर्कल्स ऑफ लाइट. हियर द फिगर ऑफ स्पीच यूज इज मेटाफर. नाउ रेनबो टिंटेड सर्कल्स ऑफ लाइट refer as multicolored bangles are compared to the bright lives of happy daughters and happy wives. The colorful bangles have been linked to the dreams, youthfulness and the desires of women of every age. So here the rainbow tinted circle is a metaphor refers to the multicolored bangles compared with the desires and passion dreams of every age group of women. Students, here in this poem we will learn about different stages of a woman, and already in the beginning I told you, you will find maiden to a maiden, then from a maiden to a bride, then to a middle aged matured lady, happy housewife, or you can say a happy mother, caring mother. So in this first stanza, students, what is the role of the bangle sellers? So basically the bangle sellers are the carriers of those shining and brightful loads, that is shining and bright bangles that glorify the idea of Indian womanhood. They try to convince the buyers, means the women of every age group, of the spiritual and symbolic importance of the bangles in the lives of maidens, brides and middle-aged women. I hope you have understood this first stanza. Let's move to the second stanza. Some are meet for a maiden's wrist, silver and blue as mountain mist. Some are flowers like the birds that dream on the tranquil brow of a woodland stream. Some are aglow with the bloom that cleaves to the limpid glory of newborn leaves. Now here you will find the word some has been frequently used. This refers to the varieties of bangles, colorful bangles. Maidens means unmarried girl. So for unmarried girls, we will see four colored bangles are shown here. First one is silver and blue colored bangles. Now here you will find the figure of speech used is simile. Silver refers or signifies purity. Blue color signifies the brightness and freshness. So this represents that the blue color sky and sea associated with freedom, depth, trust, loyalty, faith, etc. Okay, so these they are symbolic to the freshness and the beauty of the young maidens. See the next line. Some are flushed like the birds that dream. Flushed means pink or light red in color. Okay, that birds that dream. So flush symbolize the dreams and shyness of the maiden. The maidens await to get married and dream to enjoy the charms of life as the birds are waiting to bloom. The poet says they are dreaming to look forward for a beautiful future. Students, underline the birds that dream. So the figure of speech used here is personification. So the bangles are suitable for the bird-like young maidens who dream of their happy future. They dream of growing up and blossoming like beautiful flowers. Then see the next line. Some are aglow, means some are glowing like the cliffs, the fresh limpid glory of newborn leaves. Some are glowing like, some bangles are very fresh in green in color. So this color symbolize, the green color symbolize the tender nature of a maiden. So this line means that some of the bangles are glowing just like a newborn leaf that has a dew drop or waters from the stream. Underline limpid glory means the transparent glory. The dew drops on the newborn leaves make it very beautiful and fresh. Understood? So students, read these first two stanzas and try to get the proper explanations, and I shall continue in my next video.